Evening, guys. How are you? Miss you so much. I hope you have watched the last video, and I hope that you have read the story, underlined the main points, write down notes of what you see important about the story and about the ideas that the author discusses through the events of the science fiction story we have here. And even I hope that you have had a look at the vocabulary, and even looked up the vocabulary you don't know, to be able to have an enough understanding of the events and of the thoughts of the author. Now let's move to the next step of our reading, which is the critical vocabulary. Here we're gonna show the meanings and examples, and we're gonna move to contexts or contextual meanings. I'd like you to try to guess the meanings of the vocabulary in context through the given examples. The first word is enterprising. Enterprising. You can see the example here. Some enterprising girls organized a sponsored walk. Some enterprising girls organized a sponsored walk. What do you mean of enterprising? Try to guess. What kind of girls who managed to organize a sponsored walk? Exciting or excited? Maybe. Okay. I think enterprising is someone or somebody. SB is for somebody, stands for somebody. Somebody who accepts challenges and takes initiatives. Challenger. Initiative. Initiative can be a noun for something and a noun for a person. He is initiative. Takes initiatives, starts first. So, enterprising means somebody who accepts challenges and takes initiatives. The second word, the second vocab we have here, mandatory. Mandatory. Growing old is mandatory. Growing up is optional. So, mandatory is the antonym of optional. Do you remember the meaning of antonym? Yes, opposite and synonym have the same meaning. So focus on this, because we said I'm gonna ask you about this during the coming exam, inshallah. So I can ask you the antonym of mandatory. You say optional. But what about the synonym? So the opposite or the antonym of optional is obligatory or obligatory and compulsory. Obligatory, compulsory, not optional, not a choice. You have to do. So mandatory means you have to do it. Number three, the researcher sets up experiments to test the hypothesis. The researcher sets up experiments to test the hypothesis. What are the meaning of hypothesis? Of course, this word is singular. What if I'd like to form the plural of that? It's gonna be, I can't add S or ES. So, it's one of the irregular plural rules we have in English. Hypothesis is gonna be hypotheses. S-I-S in the end is going to be S-E-S. So, what do you mean of hypothesis? I need to do experiments in the lab, for example, to prove or to test this hypothesis or hypothesis. So, hypothesis means theory or possibility. So a theory or a possibility of something. It can be what it can't be. Next one. Our word is mess up. He got a second chance and didn't want to mess up again. He got a second chance and didn't want to mess up again. So what do you mean of mess up? Yes, this I think this is a word you know well. Okay. Mess up means to spoil, to screw up, to fail. So mess up means spoil or screw up. Okay? Let's move. Next. Number 5. The sentence. Some countries misjudged Corona to be a seasonal flu, not a quickly spread epidemic or epidemic. Some countries misjudged Corona to be a seasonal flu, not a quickly spread epidemic. Of course, Corona is not a flu. It's an epidemic. Epidemic is the disease that spreads quickly and has no medicine, no cure yet. So they misjudged this kind of disease. What I mean of misjudged? Yes, they had an incorrect idea about it. They had an incorrect idea about it. So misjudged means, or misjudge, of course this is the past form of misjudge, form an incorrect opinion about something or somebody. Form an incorrect opinion about something or somebody. Next, pharaohs are the ancestors of Egyptians. Pharaohs are the ancestors of Egyptians. What do you mean of ancestor? I think you know it. Ancestor means, like here, ancestor, grandpa, descendant, the opposite, grandchildren. So we are the descendants of pharaohs. So pharaohs are our ancestors. Grandpa, ancestor, grandchild, descendant. Descendant, the opposite of ancestor. Number 7. It is possible that we have traces of interstellar dust in meteorites. It is possible that we have traces of interstellar dust in meteorites. So interstellar means space among stars. I can say interstellar journey among stars, among the planets. Interstellar dust means among stars. We don't have much words here. We have 7 only with these examples. I need you to create your own examples and to study spelling, meanings, and of course, vocabulary. You know, is the vocabulary you can use, as we always say. Vocabulary, you know, is the vocabulary we can use. So, I'll give you a homework. We have now, for this video, the homework about vocabulary, critical vocabulary practice. We have here our vocabulary: enterprising, mandatory, hypothesis, misjudge, mess up, ancestor, interstellar. And I'd like you to fill in the gaps using the vocabulary to complete the sentences. Okay, as you can see, now we're gonna have 7 sentences. And I'd like, if you don't mind, I'd like to afford you some kind of nice atmosphere to be able to answer these questions. So, I'm gonna do something. If you can give me just a few minutes. I have here a kind of nice music. I'd like to play something for you, and then you can answer. Okay, now I'm gonna leave you with the practice. And of course, next video we're gonna have the answers. Go for it. We'll be right back. So that's enough for today. Waiting for your answers, either on the Facebook group, inbox. I'm available on Facebook. And next week, inshallah, we're going to see, after your answers, we're going to see the answers. I haven't forgotten about the homework of the grammar, but inshallah, as soon as possible, I'm going to prepare a video also for the answers of the grammar book pages. Do your best. Stay home. Stay safe. See you next time. And good luck, guys.